10 years ago, I used to work at Kinney's shoe store. And I was 16 years old, so I was the low man on the totem pole. And the low guy on the totem pole had to clean the bathroom every week. So I spent more time cleaning the bathroom than I did selling shoes. And one night, it was 9 o'clock, it was closing time, and a concert was on the radio that was live from the Capitol Theater, and I cranked it up. And the assistant manager came running out, you know, and in his like polyester outfit, you know, and sort of looked at me and says, "Okay, rock star, that's it, you're fired." Since then, it's been nowhere but up.
Best thing that ever happened to you.
Yeah, sure was. Or by now I could have been an assistant manager.
After the release of their multi-platinum Slippery When Wet, Bon Jovi is back with their fourth album, New Jersey.
On the 19th of September, 2 days from now, New Jersey is released. Originally, the album was going to be called Sons of Beaches.
What we didn't want to do was make Slippery Part Two, and it definitely isn't at all. We wanted to bring the kids closer, like, come on in, man. You know, like, check us out a little closer this time. You know, you saw us in this light, and it was our first impact, you know. And now it's time, you know, come on in, check it out. You know, the first song on the record is called Lay Your Hands on Me. It was kind of something to say, like, okay, so yeah, okay, we did sell the records and we did all this other stuff, but it doesn't matter, man. We need them. You know what I mean? We need that interaction. We're a live band. What you gotta do?
With the new album ready for release, the band needed a first-rate video for the first single, Bad Medicine.
We had a real hard time this year deciding what to do, like how we can be different and how we can make this video a special thing, you know, so it would really have an impact.
They turned to Wayne Isham, one of the biggest names in music video and the man behind the last three Bon Jovi videos.
Wayne Isham, in my mind, is going to be a great movie director someday. You know, I really believe that, and he worked with us 2 years ago, and the first one we did together was a Bad Name. And then we didn't think he could do better by doing Prayer, but we gave him the shot and it was even better. And then with Wanted, it really, you know, really made us happy. We've had a real good rapport, you know, and it was only the logical, you know, choice to work with him again.
These guys are musicians, and for what everyone may think of this band as pretty boys and everything, these guys are great musicians, and that's what they're all about. And that's the first thing I immediately recognize about them. And that's what I try to capture each time, is the truth, is they perform, you know what I mean? They don't pose, they perform up here. And that immediately clicked. They appreciated that someone respected them for a little more than a good-looking guy.
Wayne Isham worked his way up from the bottom, the same way the band did.
Well, he never went to film school, and so he's a natural. And, like, we're natural players. We play from here. You know, we're not like these school musicians. We're street players. And he's a street filmer, you know, and that's it's a good combination.
Though performing is what the band does best, they didn't want just another straightforward performance video.
It was a concept of desperation is what it was. I mean, everybody had done so many videos exactly like the videos that we had done, and had done them, they'd done it better than we had done them. And what other thing could we do that would be a performance of of note, and that's what these guys do. These guys take an arena and create enthusiasm and excitement, was to give the cameras to the fans.
Well, he started toying back and forth with this idea, which was exact to what it's going to be, what you're going to see at the end of this program. It's meant to be a lot of fun, and we really wanted to take what we did 2 years ago and take it to the next level, where it's not looking like other videos, where people aren't looking like us, or we're not looking like anyone else. We wanted to go to the next plateau, you know, and make the kids as much a part of it now as they were then, even more so.
As you know, Bon Jovi will be filming their new video, Bad Medicine, tonight from the brand new album, New Jersey. It's all happening right down the street at the Long Beach Arena, and we want you to be a part of it. They're going to be giving out cameras and film, and if you'd like to go down there and shoot, go for it. And if they like your footage, they might use it in the video. And right now, for you pure rockers hanging out in the parking lot, Living on a Prayer, Bon Jovi, 105.5 KNAC.
Here we are, I guess, somewhere south of Los Angeles, north of San Diego, in a place called Long Beach, California. We gave away 5,000 tickets to a Bon Jovi concert. And everybody's invited into a show. And what we did was we went out and we bought 8mm movie cameras. And we let the kids have a camera for coming. Here's, take it home with you. And went on the radio and says, if you have a video camera, bring it, shoot, and we're going to take all the film. And the very best film we're going to use in the video. Shoot whatever you want the way you see it. It could be my shoes, it could be your buddy, it could be the parking lot. Shoot anything else but what you usually see and you're forced to see by watching television.
As long as the guys are shooting and shooting the girls, in addition to Bon Jovi, we'll be in good shape.
We're waiting for that John Bon Jovi video, of which only Southern Californians can take part in. We're here, we're basically feeling pretty good, looking really happy. The crowd's here, feeling really good. Look at the crowd. The crowd's ecstatic. What can they say? They got free tickets. They can't bitch.
See everybody out there, man? These are our people, man. We love them, especially the one with the skirt.
Here, come here. He's one of our camera operators, right? He's one of our star camera operators here. See? What a beautiful concept to have that handheld up on stage.
Yeah, this is one of the girls that stayed up all night waiting
right
for
there
this
on the ground all night. I'm probably gonna catch it. Few days, I'll feel the effects.
So we all went down there, and then they started realizing who I was and started talking. And the girl there with crutches are hanging out. They're having a good old time.
Bon Jovi!
The band enlisted the help of longtime friend Sam Kinison to start the video on the right note.
Sam is going to be in the crowd of you guys. He's going to ask you a few questions that you guys will respond to. But when you hear the questions, you already know what the answers are. He's going to incite a video riot. You guys are going
to
storm the door.
Action! Hold it down! Now we're about to let you in to start the Bon Jovi video. And here's the rules. There'll be no smoking, no drinking, and cooperate with the director. Now, are there any questions?
Yeah.
Yeah, listen, I'm just kind of curious. Is this going to be the same kind of a predictable glitter rock glamour boy stock video that we always get from the same groups? They all look like the same group. Is it going to be the same kind of stock video that you guys always make?
Yes.
Well, is that good enough for you? Can we make a better video than these guys?
Directing 5,000 people isn't that easy, but Isham and the crew wanted to include the fans as much as possible.
Action! Go! Go!
About 100 fans without cameras were given Super 8s to shoot with.
I think it's really a great idea, and it's fun for the people that are going to get a chance to come and shoot it with their stuff and get a shot at being in a video. I think it's, you know, once-in-a-lifetime type thing.
You guys are all in the video, okay? So the magic is that you guys can film all this yourselves and you make the damn thing for a change, all right? All right. So as soon as we ready, Wayne, let's have some fun, okay? Let's go.
I was insane when I said, all right, the handheld crew should come on the stage now. And women just started crawling up with these short skirts on their cameras. And they're looking at me going, wait, you're nuts. You've gone too far this time.
Letting the fans shoot the video meant they got a chance to get up close to the band. Very close.
Being on stage with him was like a dream. If it happened a while ago, I would have passed out and I would have been history.
Did you dance with him? I danced with him. It was nice.
I had 11 great-looking women on stage that were into it. They weren't just out there dancing, even though they did get into it. They were picking shots and shooting things.
I didn't know whether to just freak out and, like, just die and start screaming. I had to, like, keep my composure and, you know, okay, you know, I've got to film this and I've got a job to do, you know. But I had a great time. I mean, I don't know how else to say it.
Immeasurable. It'll go down in history, you know.
Yeah, a night I will never forget.
Yeah. Yeah.